My name is Amy. This is the ASMR experiment. And I'm glad that you're here. I am. I'll tell you what. I can promise that what you all hear today in this video will include my stomach growling, because it is a magical occurrence that happens when I turn on the video camera. So, it's been a busy, noisy morning so far. So, just know that if you're new here, don't be scared when you hear that. We're coming. I promised a week ago that I was going to show you guys the things I got at Walmart on a trip there to buy things I probably didn't need, but I thought I would share those with you now, even though it's a bit late, but hopefully not too late. And I just thought some of these things I actually want to do. It's not a lot of stuff, not anything too exciting, and I want you to know that I did take something out of this box, because I found the box absolutely the most grating, unpleasant kind of box that you can come up with. All because of what's inside didn't fit, so it was just like, you know. So, sorry to Hallmark, but this box needs to go. You should redo that. Back to your packaging. For as much as they charge for their cards, I think they could do better. And don't just blame it on recycling. Anyway. So I just bought a few things and wanted to show you what they were, because I thought you might like them. So what came in the box are these cuties. These I just kind of came across, and basically nothing I bought probably was on my list, but these were some cute cards that I found. They're so sweet. They could be any kind of card. It's not really a specific thank you. It's not a specific miss you. It's not a specific good luck or see you never, congratulations, none of those. It's just kind of a overall general, well, hello there, here are some succulent plants for you to see in this card that I'm sending you. They are cute, little, super cute. I like this one with the little things, this one. And I had one like this. Kind of looking a little bit, a little sickly lately. I think I might have overwatered him, and I know you have to be so careful with that, which I always thought I was stingy on the water, but I don't really know what happened to him. So, there you go. And the envelopes are just dying. Brown paper. The card. Side, but doesn't have a note or anything, you can just put what you like in there. Make it anything you want it to be. It could be, you know, here's my receipt, you owe me half of lunch. Something like that. I quit. Cards. I think that's what I got. I'll add nice to my huge, ridiculous amount of cards that all should be sent to people, not just hoarded away like a squirrel. But I need to be more like mindful of sending them more regularly, because I love to do that. I love to write to people in like the old way, which is with a pencil and a paper and a stamp. So I bet you we have kids that have never mailed letter. In fact, I know that's true, and they don't know what a mailbox is either. We got big problems, guys. And then I also got in the season, or spirit of the season, I should say. They are a little Halloween skeletal ladies, or gents, whatever you want to say. They are so, so stinking cute, and now it's gonna be blurry. There. Look at their little tutus. They're like sisters. Sisters. I thought they were so adorable. Let me shake his hand. And yours too. So, I'm gonna wear these, I guess, on Halloween. And who knows, maybe I'll wear them in just regular days. I hope you like them. So fun. What a kind of a clever idea. I like their little rose berets. They have little roses. And they're smiling, so they must be doing all right. Dead or alive. They're dead, but yeah, super cute. So those. I haven't really come up with anything for Halloween costume. I used to dress up like all the time. And it was fun, but I'm not really, I don't know. Not really doing it as much these days. This is the other thing I got. I was so excited to have this because I had not really been indulging in candles lately because I was unemployed for a while looking for something else, and you don't really have spending money to burn on what seems silly, but it is a luxury for me. These candles, which I love, the highly scented or highly fragranced candles. This one happens to be from the Better Homes and Gardens collection. They've kind of upped their game on candles, I noticed. I believe they just have a better sense of what, no pun intended, better sense of scent. Nicer designs and better ingredient combinations, I think, to smell good. This one is uh, I love those kind of earthy, more spicy, kind of considered like the fire or earth scents. Things like amber, patchouli, sandalwood, big favorite. What else? All of the herbs like basil, thyme, lemongrass. That's another good one in here. Sage. Hi, Cha-Cha. I heard you crying. Are you meowing? Good morning. Come on upstairs. Come say hello. There she comes. Hi, kitty. Hi, mommy. What you been doing? Oh. Where you gonna go? What you gonna do? You gonna come over here and see me? Good morning, Shadow. Good morning, kitty. You're such a nice kitty. What you been doing? Did you have your breakfast? I should just take a picture of it and post it to show you, because I think it's more like seeing is believing. It's unique, and it is. What are you trying to do, kitty? Why are you doing this? Now it's back to rubbing the cord. Kitty. What you doing? You don't know, you're crazy. You're such a meow meow. You wanna smell the candle, Shadow? Here, you wanna smell? Here you go, smell it. You can smell. There you go. It smells nice. That smells really nice. I like that one. Mmm, that's good.
Oh, it smells so good. That's really good candle. She likes it. She smells everything. Loves it. She'll smell everything. So we will light the candle when we have a safe place to put it. Right now it's kind of precarious. I wouldn't recommend lighting it. Now she's gonna keep my soda. Are you coming back? Oh, that's nice. That's nice. Okay, so that was the candle. And then I also got these, which are so cute. I love these. She didn't knock that. Oh my god. It's so funny. Anyway. These are lip gloss or lip balm, I guess. Lip balm. And oh gosh, so cute. And these types of things are dangerous for me because I have a weakness. weakness for these little cute little objects, and now the world makes so many of them, so many more baby things, tiny things like these that are just beyond cute. So we have a whole bunch of flavors. This one is the strawberry. This one says orange. They even have little eyes on the top. Like little ice cubes are there. A little straw. This is the pineapple. This one is watermelon, I think. Of course, blueberry, popular. And grape, which I happen to like that. In a chapstick. So, fun. I can look at one or two if you want. So you can see at least what they There we go. I thought they were cool, and I saw them. I thought, well, if they're cute in person, they're in the wrappers. Like the straws even jiggle. That is so cute. That is so fun. It's like supposed to be like the ice cubes jiggle, you know, like in the glass. So cute. So, cheers. Cheers. I thought that we will try all the flavors, but we'll try one. This one, this is the watermelon. I was gonna say strawberry, but look, the bottom of the lid looks like really neat. And there is the chopstick inside. And I don't know if it rolls up, but actually does roll up. That's awesome. Look at that. Yay. Can you see it? That's really fucking cool. I'm really sorry. I'll try some. That's really nice. It smells really good. It smells like watermelon, for sure. Smell. sometimes you know these things, the little chibi things, they don't. They say they do, but they don't. I bought a package of, it was scent, I believe we sent different scents of like little Play-Doh clay. And yeah, no. Zero smell. Just smell like some kind of poison. I would give these to all my friends if I had a bunch of friends to give them to. I'd give them all some of these. Maybe we just send a bunch of these out to the world. It'd just make your day better to have that in your pocket. Your ice and your drink. That's so fun. So, there you go. Fun, fun, fun. And yes, I have no other reason for having these in my possession than just because I like them. Yeah, silly, but true. And then I have this. I got this. I didn't know what it was at first, but it says it's a book cover. I've never used one of these kinds of things before. When I was using book covers, I was making them out of grocery sacks, paper, brown sacks from the store that we had to keep in the kitchen. And we had a pattern we learned from each other. Other kids taught us how to do it. We cut the bags apart, fold them in a special way, use a few pieces of scotch tape, and boom. And we had book covers. They were sturdy, and you could decorate them however you wanted. A lot of people went all out. We had kids that would just do all kinds of cool stuff. I'd be like, wow. I mean, they just make them so nice. I was kind of jealous. And then there was kids that just didn't try at all. Oh my gosh. Halfway through the year, they'd have them fall apart. And they couldn't keep their books on. Book covers on. We had to have the book covers like new one or fix it or something. So, anyway, I liked making the book covers every year. It was kind of fun. I looked forward to it. Because you get to do something new. But this one, this was $1. First of all, that's a good deal. Whatever it is. But it's a fabric cover. It says it's 11 up to 10.5 inches by 11.5 inches. Fits books and binders up to that size. And there's one in here. It's a fabric book cover. And you can take it off and reuse it and rewash it in the machine. Cold or cool bleach. Let's see. Non-chlorine bleach can be used. And it recommends you hang these dry, not to put them in the dryer. I want to open it and see what it's like, but I want to show you the rest of the stuff. I'll do this soon. I'll find a book that we can put it on. I don't really know what kind of book I should put it on. But it's cool, huh? Three simple steps. On those paper ones took a lot more, but neat. Now it's a book cover. And then just don't get too crazy, but I was really excited when I saw this. This is if you haven't ever or done one of these projects before. This is a diamond dots kit. And there are lots of different designs, big and small. Some are like little kind of a kid style like this, and other ones are just regular daily adult life stuff, like kittens and puppies. I got one that I have that I haven't finished yet, but I'm working on it. Actually quite large, and they do take quite some time to do. They did a series with a bunch of famous artists like Van Gogh and different famous pieces of artwork. And my friend got this diamond dots kit that was the, if I could think of the name, I thought it was Monet. Was it, maybe it's, that might be Van Gogh. Lilies, I think, of the field, or lilies in the field. Lots of blue. I think it's irises now that I think of it. But a very beautiful and quite large piece of fabric that came with that kit. And I think the last time I saw it, I mean, there was still like a long way to go. But I think she got burned out, so she'll probably pick it back up this winter. Very pretty though. She did a poppy or like a flower that was smaller size. And then she hung it in her kitchen. And I thought it was beautiful. I didn't even know what it was. I said, "What's that so pretty?" And she told me, I said, "We gotta get one right away." Like, take me now. And I really did. I liked it so far. And I thought maybe you guys would enjoy it. I know I've seen other people doing these now and then on YouTube and elsewhere. So we could try it. And I did pick this one on purpose because I like unicorns. They are just cheerful. So I hope you guys will like to do this with me. It would be wonderful. How are they so diamondy? I don't know. They are much more sparkly than you would expect them to be. Especially when they're finished and you get them all on your canvas. They make this little pen tool that helps you stick them on. It's clever, with a little kind of gummy wax that you can dip it into to stick the diamonds, pick them up easily, and then you get this little tray that has like rows in it, little, we call those, not tunnels, but dips, I don't know, and they're like rows, and you can put your diamond dots in there and you give a little shake. And they settle down into those lanes. It makes them easier to pick up with your tool. And then you just apply them one at a time. So you're done. You follow the color code. Kind of like paint by numbers. They did invent, now of course they keep coming out with different stuff, right? That's what they do with everything, but they did come out with like multi-tools. It's a tool to make the process go faster. So instead of placing just one dot at a time, they have made these tools that pick up and place multiples. Upwards, I think, of 3 or 4 or 6 or something. I don't know how big they make them. And it just takes the timeline and accelerates it. I don't want the process to be done quickly because I'm performing a process in order to experience
relaxation or stress relief or calmness. Creative pleasure. Take my mind off of other things in life. Just kind of a relaxing and restful experience. So I don't want to just zip through it, but I think people have different timelines and different schedules and probably just don't always have the time to put it. It's just time intensive. It can be a bit. So there she is, unicorn. I hope you like it. Cute. I can't wait to open it. And then the last thing I got, which I already took out of the box, but I'll show you quick. I took them out because, well, I don't know. I was doing practice, and I don't normally practice, but I wasn't quite sure on these when they were in the box. They were kind of nice in the box, actually. Walmart. This is my final purchase of the day. And they are a set of 10. 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 washable markers from a company known as Crazy Art. Say these are new and the colors are brighter. I don't know, of course they're new. I bought them at Walmart, but as far as how bright the colors are, we'll see. They had skinny ones too, like pen shape, but I let my family member have a choice if they want some, and they chose the skinny ones. Use them sometime soon to try them out. I haven't tried them yet. They're just go anyway. So we have this one. That's your blue. It's actually azul. And then we have, there's like matching with the azul. We have the red one, and red is rojo or roja, depending on the use, I guess. Don't know if I can say what the word for pink is. Maybe it's probably like rosado. Maybe rosado. I'll have to look it up. This one looks like maybe a hot pink, which might be a different word. So then we have orange. Orange is naranja. Naranja. I remember that. Wow. That's been so long ago. Naranja. Orange. Naranja. I love that. Naranja. Name for a pretty color. We have black, very strong color, and in Spanish is negro. negro for black. I think in Tuna they say it's getting dark outside, it's obscuro, something like that. It's been so long. Maybe I have to take a class again, brush up. I took it for 6 years, but then I didn't continue. It was so long ago now, I don't remember so much of it. Basic things like the colors and the alphabet stuff. This one, yellow. 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 And yellow is a pretty name too. Amarillo. 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 Two L's. A-A. Amarillo. El sol es amarillo. I think. And this is brown. And brown is, I think it's, what is brown? Is it moreno? No. Brown, moreno. Moreno. Is that right? I don't think so. I'm not convinced that's the right word. Maybe I'll think of it. Brown. I swear it's like, then you have two greens actually. This one being kind of a light green. And green is verde. Verde. But with two greens, I don't know if you say verde, like verde major and verde minor, like the dark green versus the light green, maybe like verde como like a fruit, like lima, and then verde como arbol, like trees. I don't know, but I do know that's the only color in the box that got two slots, so green must be a pop. Is all she wrote, folks. That is the entirety of my Walmart bag. That's what I got. Approximately 7 to 8 days ago. And I apologize for the delay in getting to share it with you. The other good news, though, is I can share it because I got a computer. Yay. Huge. That just makes all the difference. So now I have a computer that I can make, edit or whatever, post videos with, record with, along with my old and true faithful friend, the Blue Yeti, and my inexpensive friend, but also very reliable so far, and that is the little webcam that I have by Logi, not Logitech, the other one, Logi, the one that doesn't come with the universal USBs, like the one that tickles, like the orange ass
know if you can reprogram those to behave like a universal USB receiver would. I don't know that. You'll have to find out. Oh. Before I go, I want to explain. Well, this is one of my favorite sweatshirts. Because it's not because it says wifey. It's wifey. Wifey. By the way, it is not true that I am anyone's wifey or plan to be. Probably ever. So, I was like, man, that's really stupid. I can't wear this sweatshirt. I love it so much, but it says wifey. What should I do? And I asked my daughter, I said, do you think I should just like try to remove the wifey before I wear it? So it's gonna be too weird. And she goes, no, don't, just leave it. And I said, oh yeah, so I'm just gonna enjoy the fact that it says that and just wear it. And people said, so I decided to go ahead and wear it. So I wear it. And, well, I mean, people that know me, they are confused, clearly. People that don't know me congratulate me. Or they want to know, like, what kind of wifey am I? I thought about taking, what was it? Oh my gosh. I told my daughter, this is my idea, before I stuck with wifey. I was going to carefully remove the part of the eye on this side somehow, like this part right here. Wait, that's not gonna work. No, I was gonna remove this much. There we go. I couldn't remember where it was, where it was stuck. Yeah, this part. So I remove the E and part of the E and the entire Y, because then the shirt would say Wi-Fi. That's hilarious. Literally would be almost funnier than wifey, just because it would say Wi-Fi, but like halfway off, there's like nothing there. Oh my gosh. I thought that was hilarious. I think I laughed like, I don't even know how many times, 5 times, same day, just thinking about it. I just go crazy laughing. But I have some stupid humor sometimes. So that is my disclaimer. I'm not trying to apply for anyone's wifey. I'm certainly not running for wifey. Not even looking to be on the campus of Wifey University. None of those things, no. I am proud to wear this shirt, though, because it was free. It is soft and nice. It has long sleeves. It's lavender. Pretty. And it has this little